SSE CGL Tier 2 Quantitative Aptitude Demo Class. Let's see Simple Interest Compound Interest class today. So, Simple Interest Compound Interest is one of the important topic in the Quantitative Aptitude. First of all, so what are the major terminology come across in the chapter? What are the major terms? So, here, the major terminology. So, here P is nothing but principal or sum. P is nothing but what am I? Principal or sum. R percent is nothing but rate of interest per annum. Rate of interest per annum. It is always considered for 1 year. So, T is the time period. T is the time period. And one more important point here. Rate of interest is always calculated on principal. Rate of interest is always calculated on principal. Whenever it is calculating on principal, we got some extra amount. That extra amount we can call it as interest. That extra amount we can call it as what am I? Interest. For the time period T. For the time period T. So here, rate of interest is always calculated for 1 year. If I need for T years, I go for R into T. I go for what am I? R into T. R into T is nothing but total rate of interest. R into T is nothing but what am I? Total rate of interest. So here, either rate of interest or total rate of interest is always calculated on principal. Is always calculated on principal. Whenever you are calculating on principal, we got some extra amount. That extra amount we can call as what? Interest. And finally, A is nothing but total amount. A is nothing but what am I? Total amount. Total amount is nothing but P plus I. Total amount is nothing but what am I? P plus I. Principal plus interest. So together we can call as total amount. Here, P is not your profit. So, A is not your profit. Only I is the profit for you. Only I is the profit for you. So, P is your money. Your money is not profit for you. On your money. So, if you earn something extra, that extra thing should be the profit for you. Only I is the profit for you. Our concentration is always is on I. So, principal plus your interest. Together we can call as what? Total amount. And generally, students are using a formula for simple interest. What is the formula for simple interest, Amma? So, PTR by 100. Yes or not? Interest I is equal to PTR by 100. That is not PTR by 100. That is a PTR percentage. I is equal to PTR percentage. I is equal to what, Amma? PTR percentage. Here, PTR percentage. These three variables are in multiplication form. In Bhutti's answers, why they are writing PTR by 100? R percentage is there na? In order to remove the percentage symbol, they are dividing with 100. So here P, T, R percentage, all the three variables are in multiplication form. Whatever subject, whatever concept. If the variables are in multiplication form, those variables are always inversely proportional to each other. Therefore, P is inversely proportional to T. So P is inversely proportional to R. So based upon these two, so I can say confidently, so P is inversely proportional to total rate of interest. P is inversely proportional to RT. P is inversely proportional to RT. Based upon this one, Amma, sometimes and they given if R into TR and the ratio A is to B, if R into TR and the ratio A is to B, then principals are in the ratio 1 by A is to 1 by B. So that is nothing but B is to A. All of you okay, Amma? So now I will discuss, first of all, what is simple interest? What is compound interest? What are the major differences between the simple interest and compound interest? Where the compound interest concept is introduced in this quantitative aptitude? What is the importance of the compound interest? First of all, I will explain the concept. So understanding the basic concept is very, very important. Once you understand the concept, the coming questions are very easy. In our Bookie's answer, they are using Bookie's methods and Bookie's formulas. So here in the entire simple interest and compound interest, we don't use any formula. So whatever problem in the compound interest and simple interest, so we are going to attack directly. In order to attack like that, first of all, so we need to understand the basic concept. First of all, I will explain the concept. Listen carefully here, all of you. First of all, I will explain simple interest. Listen carefully here, Amma. So first of all, I will explain simple interest. In simple interest, P. P is nothing but principal. So here, I don't know principal, Amma. I assume as some 100. Rate of interest and R percentage amma, rate of interest amma, here I don't know, I assume as 20%. These are my assumptions. I don't know na, I assume something. So I need simple interest for 1 year. Here I need simple interest for 1 year. Rate of interest is also calculated for 1 year na. Therefore rate of interest is 20% na. Rate of interest is always calculated on principal na. 20% of 100, 20. That extra 20 we can call as what? That extra 20 we can call as what? Interest na. Therefore, interest is 20 rupees. Amount is nothing but what amma? Amount is nothing but what? P plus I na. Amount is nothing but what? P plus I na. So, amount is nothing but what amma? 120. So, no need to use pen and paper. No need to use any formula. So, we are going to attack directly. Interest is 20. Amount is 120. For this one, students are using formula. No need to use formula. All of you okay namma? So, say for example, if I needed 2 years simple interest. If I needed 2 years simple interest. 2 years simple interest. Remember amma, the first important point in simple interest. In simple interest, every year principal is constant. Every year principal is constant. Principal doesn't change. For every year, principal is constant. Say for example, if I need 2 years simple interest, 2 years principal is also 100. 2 years interest na? 1 year rate of interest is 20% na? I need 2 years na? So 2 years rate of interest is nothing but R into T. R is 20%. T is 2 years, R into T, 20 into 2, 40%. So, 2 years total rate of interest is 40%. 40% of 100, 40. Amount become what amma? Amount become what amma? 140. Amount become what amma? 140. Say for example, similarly if I need for 3 years, if I need for 3 years, 3 years principal is what? 100. 3 years rate of interest is what amma? 60%. 60% of 100, 60. Amount become what amma? Amount become what amma? 160. If I need for 4 years, if I need for 4 years, if I need for 4 years, principal is what? 100. Rate of interest is what? 80%. 80% of 100, 80. Amount become 180. If I need for 5 years, if I need for 5 years, principal is what amma? 100. Rate of interest is what amma? 100%. 100% of 100, 100. Amount become what amma? 200. Simply remember amma, in simple interest, every year principal is constant. And one more important point here. After 1 year, what is the amount of 120 na? After 2 years, what is the amount of 140 na? 1 year or 2 years. So how many years gap is there? 1 year gap is there na? How much amount gap is there? 20 rupees gap is there na? Your principal is constant na? That extra 20 is what? That extra 20 is what? Interest only. How many years interest? 1 year interest na? Now I can say confidently, 1 year simple interest is 20. In similarly, here how many years gap is there? 1 year gap is there. Here how much amount gap is there? 20 rupees gap is there. Here how many years gap is there? 1 year gap is there. Here how much amount gap is there? 20 rupees gap is there. Here how many years gap is there? 1 year gap is there. Here how much amount gap is there? 20 rupees gap is there. Every year interest is also same na? In simple interest, finally only one point, in simple interest, every year principal is constant, every year interest is also constant. This is the final conclusion we are drafting from this explanation. This is the only point I need to say from this entire explanation. So in the entire simple interest, remember only one point, in simple interest, every year principal is constant, every year interest is also constant. So this is the practical view how the simple interest problems are going on. But in the exam point of view, how to attack directly? I will explain in the exam point of view. Here principal is what amma? 100 na? Here principal is 100 na? Rate of interest is how much andi? 20% na? How many years I need amma total? 5 years na? So total 5 years na? 20 into 5, 100% na? R into T? 100% of 100? Interest is 100 na? Amount is nothing but what amma? Amount is nothing but what amma? P plus I na? So P plus I is nothing but how much andi? 200 na? Amount is 200 na? So interest 100 rupees is getting or not? Amount 200 is getting or not? All of you clear and in the single step you are going to attack directly or not? Without using any formula, without using pen and paper. So this is the practical view amma, and this is the exam point of your attacking. In the entire simple interest, remember only one point. In simple interest, every year principal is constant, every year interest is also constant. All of you understood and this is all about simple interest. Simple interest completed. Simple interest is very, very simple. So now I will explain compound interest amma. So compound interest is very, very important compared to simple interest. It's very, very important. Most of the questions are coming from compound interest itself. So now I will explain compound interest. So compound interest is very, very important. So here in compound interest also, here P I assume as 100. I need rate of interest here also I assume as 20%. I need compound interest for first year. First year is nothing but 1 year only. Therefore rate of interest is 20%. 20% of 100, 20. Interest is 20. Amount is nothing but P plus I. So amount is nothing but what amma? 120.
Are you observe one thing, Andy? If you see the previous one, in simple interest after 1 year 120. In compound interest also, in compound interest also after 1 year 120. There is no difference between the SI and the CI for the first year. The reason is what? Whenever you are calculating rate of interest on only principal, rate of interest on only principal, that is simple interest. Whenever you are calculating rate of interest on, in addition to principal, interest on interest also, that is compound interest. Remember, Amma, only principal, simple interest. Apart from principal, interest on interest also, that is compound interest. Yo, in previous case, 20% is calculating on only principal, that is the reason this 20 we can call as what? Simple interest itself. This 20 we can call as simple interest itself. So, here 20% is calculating on only principal, therefore this 20 is simple interest itself. First year compound interest is nothing but simple interest itself. First year compound interest is nothing but simple interest itself. That is the reason for the first year there is no difference between the SI and CA. In simple interest every year principal is same, but in compound interest not like that. In compound interest every year principal vary. In compound interest, every year ending amount become next year principal. Every year ending amount become next year principal. Therefore, this 120 becomes second year principal. This 120 becomes second year principal. Second year principal is how much, Amma? Second year principal is how much? 120. Second year is nothing but 1 year only. 1 year only. So, sir, in previous case, in simple interest, we go for 2 years directly. Sir, why you are going second year separately, sir, here? In previous case, in simple interest, every year principal is same. That is the reason I go for directly 2 years directly, 5 years directly. But in compound interest, it's not possible because first year principal is different, second year principal is different. Here principal is different. That is the reason I am going for separately, first year separately, second year separately, third year separately. All of you clear, Amma? Now, second year is nothing but 1 year. Rate of interest is what, Amma? 20%. 20% on 120. 10% is 12, na? 20% is nothing but 24 na, 24 na, interest is 24, interest is 24, amount become what, Amma? 144, amount become what, Amma? 144, get 20% on 120, Amma, this 20% we are calculating on 120 na, 120 na, this 120 is nothing but this 120 na, this 120 is nothing but P plus I na, therefore this 120 is what, principal 100 U plus, principal 100 U plus, interest 20. Interest 20. Now you are calculating 20% on principal plus interest on interest also. That is the reason from the second year onwards the compound interest concept is introduced. All of you okay, Amma? So 20% of 100 is how much, Amma? 20 plus 20% of 20, 4. So 20 plus 4, 24 na. This 4 is what? This 4 is what? 20% of 20. 20% of 20. So 20% of 20, 10% on 20, 2, 20% of 20, 4, all of you clear, Amma? Now second year compound interest is 24 na? Now second year compound interest, I will explain another way. Second year compound interest is nothing but, this is very very important point, Amma, listen carefully. Second year compound interest is nothing but, first year interest 2 plus, first year interest 2 plus, interest on first year interest. Remember, second year compound interest is nothing but, first year interest 2 plus interest on first year interest. All of you clear, Amma? So after second year, what is the amount, Amma? 144. This 144 become third year principal, na? Therefore third year principal. Third year principal is what, Amma? 144. Third year is nothing but 1 year only. Rate of interest is 20%. 20% is 144. 10% is nothing but 14.4. 20% is nothing but 28.8. 28.8, so amount become what, Amma? 172.8. This 28.8 is what? Third year compound interest, na? Second year compound interest, what I told? First year interest 2 plus interest on first year interest, na? Similarly, third year compound interest is nothing but what, Amma? Second year interest 2 plus interest on second year interest. This 4.8 is what, Amma? 20% on 24. 20% on 24. 10% on 24 is nothing but 2.4. 20% is nothing but 4.8. Now we can say confidently third year compound interest is nothing but second year interest 2 plus interest on second year interest. This is the practical view how the compound interest problems are going on. This is the practical view. If you go for your bookies answer, they are using a formula. What is the compound interest formula? P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power n. So formula is like a machine. You are giving some input to, after doing some circuits, so finally they give output to. We don't know what is happening inside you. But I open that formula, I explain what is happening inside. So we need that concept. This is the practical view. So now I will explain in the exam point of view how to attack directly. So here, whenever they are asking compounded annually. Here, I assume rate of interest is 20%. I need compound interest for 3 years. Here, P I assume as 100. Rate of interest is what am I? 20%. 20% of 100, 20. Amount become what am I? 120. Again, 20% of 120. 20% of 120, 24. Amount become what am I? 144. Again, 20% of 144. 20% and 144, 28.8. It become what am I? 172.8. Is getting or not 172.8? This is the practical view. But in the exam point of view, no need to do all these things. In the exam point of view, you are going to attack like this. All of you, okay, Nandi? Sometimes in compound interest, they may ask compounded half yearly. So, half yearly, whenever they're asking half yearly. My in a year, how many half yearlys are possible? Two half yearlys, na? So the given rate of interest here, I assume as 20%. And wherever they're asking half yearly, we need to take half of the rate of interest. Whenever they're asking, question is half yearly, but the given rate of interest is for 1 year. So we need to take half of the rate of interest. So rate of interest is what am I? 10%. I need compound interest for one and a half years. Compounded half yearly. 1.5 year. In 1.5 year time, how many half yearlys are possible? 3 half yearlys are possible. Na? Then I go for 3 years. Na? Is it possible to go for 1 year first and then half year next? It's not possible because they mentioned very clear. So that is nothing but what? Half yearly. Whenever they mention half yearly, we need to go every 6 months once. Here P I assume as 100. Rate of interest is what? 10%. 10% of 100. 10. It become 110. So this is after 6 months. Again, 10% and 110. 10% and 110. 11. So it become 121. Again, 10% of 121. 10% of 121. So 12.1. So it become 133.1. In a similar approach, all of you okay, Nandi? So sometimes in compound interest, they may ask compounded quarterly. So wherever they're asking compounded quarterly, first of all, tell me quarter is nothing but how many months? Quarter is nothing but 3 months. In a year, four quarterlies are there. So four quarterlies. Here I assume rate of interest is 20. So wherever they're asking compound quarterly, we need to take 1/4 of the rate of interest. Because four quarters are there. So 1/4 of the rate of interest is nothing but how much am I? 5%. So here I need compound interest for 6 months. In 6 months time period, how many quarterlies are possible? Two quarters are possible. Na? Then I go for two cycles. Na? Here, P I assume as 100. Rate of interest is how much am I? 5%. 5% of 105. It become 105. This is after 3 months. Again 5% and 105. 10% is nothing but 10.5. 5% is nothing but 5.25. So it become 110.25. It become what am I? 110.25. This is what am I amount. So wherever they're asking compounded annually, compounded half yearly, compounded quarterly, your way of attacking is similar or not. This is the practical view, ma, and this is the exam point of your attacking. This is all about what is simple interest, what is compound interest. Once again, I will give the overview, ma. In simple interest, every year principal is same, every year interest is also same. In compound interest, every year principal is different, every year interest is also different. For the first year, there is no difference between the SA and CA. The reason is whenever you are calculating rate of interest on only principal, that is simple interest. Whenever you are calculating rate of interest on in addition to principal, interest on interest also, that is compound interest. But that is the reason for the first year there is no difference between the simple interest and compound interest. The second year compound interest is nothing but first year interest 2 plus interest on first year interest. Similarly, third year compound interest is nothing but second year interest 2 plus interest on second year interest. So this is what simple interest and compound interest. All of you okay, namma? Then I will go for the questions and the examples. We'll see some examples. Okay, namma? Just read the question, amma. Mr. Patel borrows 10,000 rupees at 20% per annum for 5 years at simple interest, but from the fourth year onwards on the entire amount due at the end of 3 years, the lender begins to charge 20% per annum interest compounded annually. What is the amount repaid by Mr. Patel after 5 years from the beginning? So total time period is 5 years. So principal is 10,000. So, but here for the first 3 years, that is simple interest. But after 3 years, 20% per annum compound interest for the remaining 2 years. First 3 years, simple interest. Fourth year and fifth year, that is compound interest. After 3 years, what is the amount is there? That amount is the principal for the fourth year compound interest. All of you clear? So first of all, I will explain orally. Here principal is 20,000. Rate of interest is 20% for the first 3 years simple interest na. So 3 × 20% 60% na. 60% and 10,000. 60% and 10,000, 6,000 na. Simple interest is 6,000. 6,000 plus principal 10,000. Amount is 16,000 after 3 years. That amount become principal for the fourth year. That is compound interest. Now, compound interest rate of interest is what? Compound interest rate of interest is also 20%. 16,000 is the principal. Now, rate of interest is 20%. It's not possible to calculate fourth year and fifth year directly. You have to calculate fourth year separately, fifth year separately, because fourth year and fifth year is compound interest. Compound interest is not possible to calculate 2 years directly. So, fourth year. Rate of interest is 20%. 20% is 16,000. So 10% is 1600, 20% is 3200 plus 16,000, 19,200. So our answer is more than 19,200, because how to calculate fifth year also, now? So our answer is more than 19,200. See the options, more than 19,200, only one option is there. There is nothing but the 23,040. If you want the answer, I will calculate. So here, after fourth year, so 19,200 na, again 20% is na, 10% is 1920. 20% is nothing but 3840, 19,200 plus 3840. That 800 add to this 19,200, it become 20,000. The remaining is 3040. 20,000 plus 3040, 23,040. 23,040. So your answer is 23,040. Option D is the right answer. Once again, I will explain on the board, don't worry. But in the exam, we are going to attack it directly without using pen and paper. So, I will explain once again, don't worry. So, principal is what? 20,000. Principal is what? 20,000. For the first 3 years, simple interest only, rate of interest is 20%. 3 × 20, 60%. 60% and, principal is 10,000. So, principal is 10,000. Principal is 10,000. 60% and 10,000. 60% and 10,000 is how much, amma? 6,000. Amount become what, amma? 16,000. This is after 3 years. Now, for the fourth year, rate of interest is 20%. Compound interest. 20% and 16,000. 10% is nothing but 1600. 20% is nothing but 3,200. If I add, it become 19,200. This is after 4 years. See the options. I need to calculate fifth year also, but no need to calculate in the exam. See the options. Our answer is more than 19,200. Which option is there? More than 19,200. Only one option. In the exam, we are going to attack directly. But if you want answer, I will calculate. 20% is 19,200. 10% is nothing but 1920. Just remove 0. 1920. 20% is nothing but 1920 plus 1920, 3840. Now look at me, Amma. So how we are adding this 3840 to 19200? Don't worry. Here 800 is there, na? Here 800 is there, na? That 800 just add to 19200. It become 20,000, na? Remaining is 3040, na? Therefore your answer is what? 23,040. So amount is nothing but what, Amma? 23,040. So option D is the right answer. All of you understood, Amma? Shall I go for next question? See the next question, Amma. Find the compound interest on 9375 at 8% per annum for 2 years. So here, if we use formula, compound interest formula P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power N, definitely it will take some time. But we don't use that formula. First of all, I will explain orally. So here, principal is what, Amma? 9375 now. Rate of interest is nothing but 8%. Na? First of all, 9375 is the principal. Rate of interest is 8%. Okay? 1% is nothing but 93.75. 8% is nothing but 8 into 93.75. 890 is 720. 83 is 24. 8.75 is 6. 720 plus 24, 744. 744 plus 6, 750. First year interest is 750. Second year compound interest is nothing but I already told. First year interest 2 plus interest on first year interest. 750 plus 8% than 750. 1% is nothing but 7.5. 8% is nothing but 8 into 7.5. 8 7 is 56. 8.5 is 4. 4 plus 56, 60. 750 plus 60, 810. 810 plus 750, 1560. Your answer is 1560. So 1560. Option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. In the exam, we are going to attack like this. If you use formula, definitely it will take some time. So don't worry, Amma. Once again, I will explain on the board. Don't worry. Once again, I will explain the board. Just look at me, all of you. So here, principal is what, Amma? 9375. Rate of interest is what, Amma? 8%. First of all, 1%. 1% is nothing but 93.75, na? 93.75, na? I need 8%. 8 into 93.75. Look at me, Amma. How I am multiplying? 8 into 9. 8 9 is how much? 72. 8 9s are 72. Amma, but this is not 9. This is 90. 8 90s are 720. 8 3s are 24. 24 plus 720. 744. 8 into 0.75. 8 into 0.75. 8.75 is 6 na. 75 6 is 600 na. Therefore, 8 into 0.75 6 na. 6 into 744 750. Your first year interest is 750. Your first year interest is what? 750. Some students are doing what to this 750 is added to 975. They got this much. How much? This much. And that much, if you calculate 8%, definitely it will take so much time. Na? Because 8% of this bigger value, definitely it will take some time. That is the reason I told. Second year compound interest is nothing but. So I already told. Second year compound interest is nothing but first year interest 2 plus. So interest on first year interest. 8% on 750. 8% on 750. Now tell me, 8% of this bigger value is easy or 8% on 750 is easy? 8% and 750 is easy, na? That is the reason I told. We need concept. We need concept. We solve the questions through concept, not formulas. So 8% on 750. Now tell me, 1% is nothing but 7.5. 1% is nothing but 7.5. 8% is nothing but 8 into 7.5. 8 into 7.5. 8 7 is 56. 8.5 is 4. 4 plus 56, 60. 750 plus 60. 750 plus 60. So no need to calculate amount. So we need interest. First year interest is 750. Second year interest is 750 plus 60. 750, 750, 1500. 1500 plus 60, 1560. So your answer is 1560. All of you okay, Amma? So without using formula, without using pen and paper, we are going to attack directly. All of you clear, Amma? Just make a note, Amma. Shall I go for the next question? See the next question. The difference between the simple interest and compound interest for the fourth year is 7280. At 20% per annum, what is the principal? So, they are asking fourth year difference, not 4 years difference. Make a underline. So, they are asking fourth year difference, not 4 years difference. Is there any formula to find out fourth year difference? Is there any formula in our bookie's answers? It's not possible. So, but we are going to attack directly. Look at me, Amma. First of all, I will explain orally. Here, principle, I don't know. I assume as 100. I assume as what, Amma? 100. First, I will calculate fourth year simple interest. In simple interest, every year interest is same. Therefore, first year interest is 20% or 100, 20. Second year interest is also 20. Third year simple interest is also 20. Fourth year simple interest is also 20. Because in simple interest, every year interest is same. If I assume principal is 100, fourth year simple interest is 20. Similarly, fourth year compound interest. So, principal is 100, rate of interest is 20%. 20% on 100, 20, it become 120. Again, 20% on 120, 24, it become 144. Again, 20% on 144, 28.8, it become 172.8. Again, 20% on 172.8, 34.56. That 34.56 is, that 34.56 is 4th year CA. 4th year SA is 20, 4th year CA is 34.56. Difference is what? 14.56. So, according to 100, the difference between the SA and CA for the 4th year is 14.56. But according to our problem, 7280. 14.56 is there na? 7280 is there na? How many times it goes to? That many times it goes to. 14.56 is there. 14 is there, 70 is there. 14, 5 is 70. It goes exactly 500 times. 500 times of 100, 50,000. Your answer is 50,000. So, your answer is 50,000. Option B is the right answer. Once again, I will explain. Don't worry. Once again, I will explain. Don't worry. So, here, principal I assume as 100. First year SA is 20. Second year SA is 20. Third year SA is also 20. Fourth year SA is also 20. This is fourth year SA. This is fourth year SA. Because in simple interest, every year interest is same. Coming to compound interest. Coming to compound interest, 20% of 100, 20. It become what? 120. Again, 20% of 120, 24. It become 144. Again, 20% of 144, 28.8. It become 172.8. Again, 20% of 172.8, 34.56. Because 10% is nothing but 17.28. 17.28 plus 17.28, 34.56. This 34.56 is what? Fourth year CA. Now I need difference. So difference is how much, Amma? Difference is how much? 14.56 na. According to 100, if your principal is 100, your difference is 14.56. But according to 100, so this is 7280. How many times it goes to? That many times it goes. So, 14.56, how many times, Amma? 14 is there, 70 is there. Exactly, it goes 5 times, na? The 2 decimals are there, that is the reason 500 times. Therefore, 500 times of 100, that is nothing but what, Amma? 50,000. Your answer is 50,000. In the exam, no need to draw this design, Sunday. In the exam, we are going to attack directly. Find the compound interest on 10,248, 6 1 by 4 percentage. This is mixed fraction, Amma. 6 1 by 4 percentage. 6 1 by 4 percentage per annum for 2 years 73 days. So 2 years 73 days. If you use formula P into 1 plus R by 100 whole power N, in place of N, we need to substitute 2 1 by 5. That is nothing but 11 by 5. Definitely it will take some time. Okay, Namma? But we are going to attack directly. So here, I will explain orally first. Again, I will explain on the board, Amma. Just look at me, all of you. So here, principal is 10,240. Rate of interest is 6 1 by 4. 6 1 by 4 percent is nothing but 1 by 16 fraction. Principal is 10,240. Rate of interest is 1 by 16. 1 by 16 of 10,240. 640. Because 6 are 96. Remainder is 6. 4 is there, 64. 16 4 is 64. 0 is there. First year interest is 640. Second year interest is nothing but 640 plus 1 by 16 of 640. 40. Because 16 4s are 64. So 640 plus 40. 680. Second year compound interest is 680. Third year compound. First of all, I have to calculate third year. After calculating third year interest, I have to calculate 73 days interest. How to calculate third year compound interest? Second year interest 2 plus interest on second year interest. 680 plus 1 by 16 of 680. 1642.5 hours. 680 plus 42.5, 722.5. 722.5 is third year interest. But I need only 73 days interest. In a year, 365 days are there. So out of 365, I need only 73. 73 by 365 is nothing but exactly 1 by 5. 75 times 350, 35 is 15. 15 by 350, 365. Exactly 1 by 5. 1 by 5th of 722.5. 1 by 5th of 722.5. 5144.5 times. 5140 just 700. 54 just 25. 0.5 just 2.5. That is nothing but 722.5. Therefore, 73 days interest is nothing but 144.5. First year interest is 640. Second year interest is 680. 640, 680. 1320. 1320 plus 144.5. 1464.5. Your answer is 1464.5. Option A is the right answer. In the exam, we are going to attack like this. So if you use formula, definitely it's not possible. If you practice, then definitely you will get this much command. All of you okay, Amma? So don't worry, Andy. Once again, I will explain the board. Just look at me, Amma. Just look at me, Andy. So principal is 10,240. Principal is 10,240. So rate of interest is how much, Amma? Rate of interest is how much, Amma? 1 by 16. 6, 1 by 4 is nothing but 1 by 16. So 1 by 16 of 10,240. So 16 6 are 96. Remainder is 6. 4 is there, 64. 16 4s are, so answer is 640. First year CA is 640. So no need to calculate amount. No need to calculate amount. Second year CA is nothing but 640 plus 1 by 16 of 640. 1 by 16 of 640. So 16 4s are 64 na. Therefore, second year interest is what am I? 680. 640 plus this is 40. 640 plus 40, 680. So first of all, calculate third year compound interest. How to calculate third year? 680 plus 1 by 16 of 680. 1 by 16 of 680. So here 680 plus cancel with 6 number. 16 4s are 64. 16 2s are 32. 16.5s are 8. So 680 plus 42.5. That is nothing but 722.5. 722.5 is third year interest. I need only 73 days interest. So in a year, 365 days are there. 73 by 365 is nothing but 1 by 5. 75 is 350, 35 is 15. 15 plus 350, 365. Exactly 1 by 5. So 1 by 5th of 722.5. That is nothing but 144.5. 144.5. First year interest is 640. Second year interest is 680. 73 days interest is, so 144.5. If I add all these three, so that is nothing but 640, 680, 1320 plus 144.5. So 1464.5. So option A is the right answer. Option A is the right answer. So in the exam, so no need to draw these designs, Amma. So we are going to attack directly. Okay, Amma. Can I go for the next question? Read the question, Amma. A man borrowed some money from a private organization at 5% simple interest per annum. He lent 50% of this money to another person at 10% per annum compound interest. And thereby, the man made a profit of 3205 in 4 years. The man borrowed is how much? So, a man borrowed some money from a private organization at 5% per annum simple interest. He lent 50% of this money to another person at 10% compound interest. In this way, he is getting 3205 interest in 4 years. First of all, the man borrowed is how much? I don't have any money. I borrowed somewhere at simple interest, 5% per annum. I borrowed. 50% of the money I lent to another person at compound interest at 10% per annum. I borrowed simple interest. I lent compound interest. Definitely in this way, I am getting profit or not. In 4 year span, I am getting 3205 interest, 3205 profit. Then how much I borrowed? This is the question. All of you understood the question. First of all, I will explain orally. Then I will again explain on the board. So first of all, I don't know how much I borrowed. How much I borrowed, I don't know. Here, I assume principal is 200. I assume principal is what amount? 200. Why I am assuming 200? If I assume 100, 50% of the money I lent to another person. So definitely it will take some time to calculate on 54 years compound interest. So that is the reason I assume I borrowed 200 rupees. So simple interest is 5% rate of interest na for 4 years na 5 into 4 20% na 20% on 200 40. 20% on 200 40. So amount is nothing but 240. So I need to pay 240 rupees. So out of 200, 100 rupees with me only. 50% of the money with me only. Remaining 50%. 50% of 200 is nothing but 100. The remaining 100 I lend to compound interest. So at 10% per annum for 4 years. So rate of interest is 10%. 10% on 100, 10, it become 110. Again 10% on 110, 11, it become 121. Again 10% on 121, 12.1, it become 133.1. Again 10% on 133.1, 13.31. 13.31 plus 133.1, 146.41. So according to compound interest, I am getting 146.41. And remaining 50% with me only, na? That 100, na? 100 plus 146.41, 246.41. But I need to pay only 240. I am getting 246.41. Remaining 6.41 is the profit for me, na? According to 200, 6.41. But according to our problem, 3205. 6.41 is there, na? 3205 is there, na? How many times it goes? Exactly. 6.41, 3205. 6 is there, 30 is there. Exactly, it goes 500 times. 500 times of 200. 500 times of 200 is nothing but 1 lakh. Your principal is 1 lakh. Your answer is B. Option B is the right answer. Don't worry, Amma. One second, I will explain on the board. So, here, I borrowed 200 rupees simple interest. Rate of interest is 5%. For how many years? Under 4 years. 5 into 4, 20%. 20% on 200, that is nothing but 40. So, it become what amount? 240. So I need to pay 240 rupees. Where I am borrowing? Out of 200, 50% of the money. 50% of the money is nothing but 100. So 50% of the money only. Okay. So I lend to another person at compound interest at 10% per annum. 10% of 100, 10. It become 110. Again 10% and 110, 11. It become 121. Again 10% of 121, 12.1. It become 133.1. Again 10% of 133.1, 13.31. It become 146.41. And remaining 50% of the money with me only. Remaining 50% of the money, that is nothing but 100. So total I have with 246.41. Total I have with 246.41. So according to 200, I am getting how much profit, Amma? Out of 246.41, I need to pay 240, na? Out of 246.41, I need to pay 240, na? The remaining profit is how much? 6.41. According to 200, my profit is 6.41. But according to our problem, my profit is 3205. So how many times it goes, Amma? 6, 5 is 30, na? Two decimals are there, na? I put two zeros. So 500 times. Therefore, 500 times of 200. So 500 times of 200 is nothing but how much, Andy? So 1 lakh. So 500 times of 200 is nothing but 1 lakh. Therefore, your answer is what, Amma? 1 lakh. All of you clear, Andy? So read the question, Amma. Rupees 16,820 is divided between two brothers of age 27 years and 25 years. They invested their money at 5% per annum compound interest in such a way that both will receive equal money at the age of 40 years. The share of elder brother is how much? So here, 16,820 is divided between two brothers of age 27 years and 25 years. They invested their money at 5% per annum compound interest in such a way that both will receive equal money at the age of 40 years. Here, if you observe carefully, here, elder one age is 27 years, younger one is 25 years. Chinnababu age is 25 years, Peddababu age is 27 years. Both will receive equal amount at the age of 40. Therefore, here, Chinnababu is getting 15 years interest, but Peddababu is getting only 13 years interest. Yes or not? So 13 years interest. So Chinnababu is getting 15 years interest, but Peddababu is getting 13 years interest. Which Babu is getting more interest? Chinnababu is getting more interest because Chinnababu is receiving 15 years interest. Peddababu is receiving only 13 years interest. Therefore, in terms of interest, Chinnababu is getting more, Peddababu is getting less. But both will get equal amount. Amount should be equal. So in order to equal the amount, in which account we should put more principal, Amma? Pedababu account, because Pedababu is receiving less interest na. If you put more principal in Pedababu account, then definitely both will receive equal amount, there is a 40. So more amount is, more principal is nothing but more than half. Total principal is what? 16,820 na. Total principal is 16,820 na. Half is nothing but 8,410. Half is nothing but 8,410. But your answer should be more than 8,410 na. See the options, more than 8,410, which option is there? More than 8,410, which option is there? 8,820. Your answer is 8,820. Straight away we are going to attack directly. All of you got the logic? So Chinna Babu is getting more interest, Pedda Babu is getting less interest. That is the reason I am putting more principal in Pedda Babu account in order to get equal amount at the age of 40. More principal is nothing but more than half. Half is nothing but 8,410. Your answer is more than 8,410. See the options, more than 8,410, which option is there? All of you clear? And I will explain the original method also. Sometimes more than a half, two more options are there. Otherwise, if they ask, find the share of each brother. So that is the reason I will explain the original method also. Here, rate of interest is 5%. Rate of interest is 5%. 5% is nothing but 1 by 20. 5% is nothing but what, 1 by 20. Here, younger one, elder one. Elder one, I should put more. Younger one, this is the 1 by 20. It's a fraction. Fraction is nothing but a part of whole thing. Whole thing, this is the total. So 20 parts I put in the younger one account. But I should put more principal in elder one account. So I should put more. Whenever we got more, meaning extra, increase, greater. So simply do one thing, numerator is added to denominator. If 1 is added to 20, it become 21. It become what? 21. Therefore, 20 parts I should put in the younger one account, and 21 parts I put in the elder one account. So elder one account. So here, the age gap between younger one and elder one is how many years? Age gap is 2 years na. Age gap is 2 years na. That is the reason I'm going for squares. Each one square. If the gap is 3 years, we go for cubing. Okay, namma. So 20 square is nothing but 400 parts. 21 square is nothing but 441 parts. So total it is 841 parts. According to our problem, 16,820. So 841, how many times, amma? 20 times. They're asking younger one account, younger one or elder one, whatever it may be. So 20 × 400, that is nothing but 8,000. So 20 × 441. So 20 × 441, that is nothing but 8,820. They're asking elder one account, that is nothing but 8,820. 8,820 plus 8,000, 16,820. This is the original method to solve this one. If only one option is there, then we are going to attack directly. All of you understood, namma? So 5% is nothing but 1 by 20 fraction. And so 20 parts in younger one account. So whenever we got more extra profit, numerator is added to whatever value in the numerator, numerator is added to denominator. That is the reason 21 parts in the elder one account. The gap is 2 years. That is the reason I am going for squaring. If the gap is 3 years, we go for cubing. All of you okay, namma? Shall I go for the next question? So read the question, namma. The population of a vultures in a particular locality decreases at the rate of at a certain rate. If the current population of a vultures be 29,160 and the ratio of the decrease in the population for second year and third year be 10:9, what was the population of vultures 3 years ago? So here they given present vultures population. This is present population. They are asking 3 years ago population. 3 years ago, the decreasing rate, the depreciation rate, the depreciation rate. So is the ratio is 10:9. Here the depreciation rate, the rate of interest, that is nothing but depreciation percentage they given in terms of ratio. 10 parts become 9 parts. Depreciates by 1 part na. So change by initial value. Initial value is what? 10 na. So 1 by 10 is nothing but 10%. Therefore, depreciation rate is 10%. Depreciation rate is what, amma? 10%. Indirectly they mentioned. 10 parts become 9 parts. 10 parts become 9 parts. So second year to third year is nothing but 1 year only. Therefore, rate of interest is always calculated for 1 year. And one more important point, amma, wherever they're asking growth rate problems or depreciation problems, we are going to solve these growth rate or depreciation problems through compound interest methodology. So here depreciation rate is nothing but 10%. So present vultures population, I know they're asking 3 years ago. 3 years ago, what is the vultures population? First of all, I will explain orally, Emma. I don't know 3 years ago vultures population. I assume as 100. depreciation rate is 10%. 10% of 100, 10, it become 90. Again, 10% of 90, 9, it become 81. Again, 10% of 81, 8.1. If I subtract 8.1 from 81, that is nothing but 72.9. According to 100, 72.9. But according to our problem, 29,160. 72.9 is there now. 29,160 is there now. Exactly, it goes 400 times. 400 times of 100, 40,000. Your answer is 40,000. So, 3 years ago, vultures population is 40,000. Don't worry, Emma. One second, I will explain the board. So, here 3 years ago, I don't know vultures population, Emma. I assume as 100. So, depreciation rate is 10%. 10% of 100, 10. 10% of 100, 10. It become what, Emma? 90. So, again, 10% of 90. Again, 10% of 90, 9. So, it become what, Emma? 81. Again, 10% of 81. Again, 10% of 81, 8.1. 8.1. It become what, Emma? 72.9. This is what, Amma? This is what, Amma? Present to. Present to vultures population. Present to vultures population. According to 100, 72.9. But according to our problem, 29,160. How many times it goes? That many times it goes. Okay. So, here, don't worry, Amma. 7 is there, 29 is there. 7 table, 29 goes 4 times. So, it goes exactly 400 times. Because here, 1 decimal is there. That is the reason 10. Here, 1 more 0 is there. That is the reason 1 more 0. Total 400 times. 400 times of 100. 400 times of 100. 40,000. So, your answer is what, Amma? 40,000. All of you clear, Andy? So, remember one point. Wherever they are asking growth rate problems or depreciation problems, we are going to solve. So, through compound interest methodology. Okay, Amma? Next question, Amma. Read the question, Amma. The compound interest on a sum of money for 2 years is 832 and the simple interest on the same sum for the same period is 800. That difference between the compound interest and simple interest for 3 years will be dash. So here, first I will explain orally, Amma, here. So 2 years simple interest is 800. 2 years compound interest is 832. They're asking the difference between the SA and CA for 3 years. First of all, 2 years simple interest is 800 na. In simple interest, every year interest is same na. Therefore, first year simple interest is 400. Second year simple interest is 400. Third year simple interest is also 400. Because every year it is same. First year 400. Second year 400. Third year is also 400. Coming to compound interest. 2 years compound interest is 832 na. I already told, for the first year, there is no difference between SA and CA. Therefore, first year SA become first year CA na. Therefore, first year SA is 400. First year CA is also 400 na. First year CA is 400, 2 years CA is 832, then automatically second year CA is what? Remaining 432 na? So second year CA is 432. What I told, second year CA, what I told, first year CA plus interest on interest na? Therefore that 432 is nothing but 400 plus 32 na? That 32 is interest on 400 na? 32 is how much percentage on 400? 8% na? So rate of interest is 8%. Now, how to calculate third year compound interest? I already told third year compound interest is nothing but second year compound interest 2 plus interest on second year compound interest. So, here 432 plus 8% and 432. So, 1% is nothing but 4.32, 8% is nothing but 8 4s are 32, 8 4s are 32. So, here I need 8% on 432. 8 4s are 32, 8.32s are 832s are 256, 8 2. So, 0.32 as 2.56. Now, first year 400, 400 get cancelled. Second year 400, 400 get cancelled. Difference is 32. Third year also 400, 400 get cancelled. In 432, 32, 32, 32. Total 332s are there. 332s as 96. So 2.56 extra is there. 2.56 plus 92. That is nothing but. So 98 point. So 36, 36. So 32, 32, 32, 96 plus 2.56, 98.56. So your answer is what, Amma? 98.56. Option C is the right answer. Once again, I will explain the board, Amma. Don't worry. Yo, so 2 years SI they given. 2 years SI they given. So 2 years SI is 800. So every year SI is same. First year it is 400. Second year is also 400. So third year is also 400. All of you clear, na? So 2 years CI. So 2 years CI is 832. First year it is same. First year it is same. That is nothing but 400 only. Second year is the remaining 432. So this 432 is nothing but first year interest 2 plus 32. This 32 is interest on 400. Therefore, rate of interest is what, Amma? 32 is how much percentage on 400? Exactly 8%. So how to calculate third year interest? 432. This 432 I am going to written as 400 plus 32. Now I need to calculate 8% on 432. 8% on 432. So 8%. So 10%. Amma 8% and 8% on 400 is how much? 32 plus 8% on 32. So 1% is nothing but 0.32. 8% is nothing but 2.56. Because 832s are 256. 8 to 0.32 is 2.56. Now I need a difference. No need to add amma. First year there is no difference. First year there is no difference. Second year this 400 get cancelled. Difference is 32. So third year this 400 get cancelled. 32, 32, 32. 32, 32, 32. 3 32s are 96. Plus 2.56. 96 plus 2.56. 98.56. Option C is the right answer. So in the exam, no need to write all these things, amma. In the exam, we are going to attack directly. All of you clear, andi? Just to make a note, amma. Shall I go for the next question? Just read the question, amma. Consider the following statements. If your money is lent at simple interest, then money gets a triple in 10 years if the rate of interest is 16.2/3%. Money gets triple in 10 years if the rate of interest is 20%. Money becomes 4 times in 10 years if it gets double in 5 years. Of these statements, which are correct? Which statements are correct? Look at me, all of you here. Money gets a triple in 10 years. I don't know that principle. I assume as 100. If I assume principle as 100, money gets a triple. Triple is nothing but 100 become 300 na. Therefore, interest is 200 na. 200 rupees interest in how many years, amma? So 200 rupees interest in how many years? 10 years. So 200 rupees interest in 10 years, amma. Therefore, rate of interest is what? 16.2/3. Is it possible? 16.2/3. It's not possible, na. So first statement is wrong. First statement is wrong. Coming to the second statement, money gets a triple in 10 years if the rate of interest is 20%. Money gets a triple. Therefore, interest is 200. Interest is 200. So interest is 200. 1 year interest is 20%. Therefore, 10 years interest is nothing but 200. Yes, second statement is true. Second statement is true. Coming to the third statement, money becomes 4 times. Money becomes 4 times is nothing but 100 become 400. Interest is 300. Interest is 300. So if it gets a double in 5 years, if it gets a double in 5 years, double in 5 years is nothing but 200 rupees interest in 5 years. 100 rupees interest in 5 years, then 300 rupees interest in 15 years na, but they given 10 years na, so it's not possible. Third statement is also false. First statement is false. Third statement is false. 2 is alone right. So see the option, someone, 2 is alone right. Where is they? So option C. Option C is the right answer. So once again I will explain, amma, don't worry. So first statement, money gets a triple in 10 years. Here I don't know principle, I assume as 100. Triple is nothing but 3 times, amount is 300. Amount is nothing but P plus I. Amount is nothing but P plus I. So out of 300, 100 is the principal. Remaining 200 is the interest. 200 rupees interest in how many years, amma? So 10 years. 10 years. 10 years. 10 years 200. Therefore, 1 year rate of interest is nothing but what, amma? 1 year is nothing but 20. Therefore, rate of interest is 20%. Therefore, rate of interest is 20. If rate of interest is 20%, then only it is possible. Money become 300, triple in 10 years span. So first statement is false. First statement is false. All of you clear, amma? Money becomes triple in 10 years if the rate of interest is 20%. Yes. So by using this one, I can say confidently, first statement is wrong, second statement is true. All of you clear, amma? Now coming to third statement. Money becomes 4 times in 10 years if it gets double in 5 years. If it gets in double in 5 years, nothing but, here I don't know principle, I assume as 100. 100 become double. Double is nothing but what, amount? 200. Amount is 200. P plus I. In this 200, principal is 100. Therefore, remaining is what, amount? 100. This 100 rupees in how many years, amount? 5 years. If it gets in double in 5 years, they're asking, money becomes 4 times. Money becomes 4 times is nothing but amount become 400. Amount become 400. Amount is nothing but P plus I, na? Therefore, interest is how much, amount? 300. Interest is 300. So here, 100 rupees in 5 years, then 300 rupees in how many years? 300 rupees in 15 years na. But they given how many years? But they given how many years? 10 years. Is it possible? No. So third statement is also false. Out of 3, which one is alone right, amma? So 2 is alone right. 2 is alone right. In the exam, no need to draw this design, amma. In the exam, we are going to attack directly. All of you clear, andi? Can I go for the next question? So read the 10th question, amma. Rupees 1 lakh was invested by Mohan in a fixed deposit at the rate of 20% per annum at compound interest. However, every year he has to pay 50% tax on the compound interest. So how much money does Mohan has got after 4 years? So here, rate of interest is 20%, and he is getting 20% compound interest. He has to pay 50% tax on the compound interest. 50% tax on the compound interest. He is getting 20 rupees, for example. Out of 20 rupees, he has to pay 50% tax. So, every time you have to calculate compound interest, every time you have to deduct that tax, so you wanted to go for like that. Simply, here rate of interest is 20%. Out of 20%, I need to pay 50% tax. So, 50%, 20%, that is nothing but 10%. Therefore, straight away, I am going to take, straight away, I am going to take 10% is the rate of interest. If I assume 10% is the rate of interest, your principal is what? 1 lakh na? In place of 1 lakh, I assume as 100. If I assume 100, rate of interest is 10% na? 10% on 100, 10, it become 110. Again 10% on 110, 11, it become 121. Again 10% on 121, 12.1, it become 133.1. Again 10% on 133.1, 13.31. 13.31 plus 133.1, 146.41. But according to our problem, that is not 100, that is 1 lakh. It goes 1000 times of 146.41, that is nothing but 1,46,410. Your answer is 1,46,410. Option D is the right answer. Don't worry, Amma. Once again, I will explain the board. Your rate of interest is 20%. Whatever amount I am getting through interest, I need to pay 50% tax. That is the reason in the rate of interest itself, I am deducting that 50%. I am considering only 10% is the rate of interest. Your principal is 1 lakh. In order to take 1 lakh, I assume as 100 because it's very easy. So, rate of interest is not 20 because out of 20%, I need to deduct 50% tax. 10% on 110, it become 110. Again, 10% on 110, 11, it become 121. Again, 10% of 121, 12.1, it become 133.1. Again, 10% of 133.1, 13.31, it become 146.41. So, in terms of 146.4, no need to equate also. In terms of 146.41, which option is there? So, according to 100, 146.41, this is not 100, this is what, Amma? This is what, Amma? 1 lakh, na? 1 lakh, na? So, how many times it goes? 1000 times, na? 1000 times, na? Therefore, 1000 times of 146.41. So, that is exactly 1,46,410. Your answer is 1,46,410. In the exam, no need to draw these designs. All of you okay, Amma? Just to make a note, Amma. Shall I go for the next question? Just read the question, Amma. If a certain sum of money at the rate of compound interest annually becomes 4 times in 6 years, in how much time it will become 256 times. So wherever they're asking this type of questions, some of 4 times na, put 4 as a base. Total how many times I need? 256 times. In the power of 4, what I substitute, then I will get 256. So in order to get 256, amma, 256 is 16 square na. Therefore 4 to the power of 4. So, one cycle, how many years it will take? One cycle, it will take 6 years. Na? One cycle, it will take 6 years. And so, 6 cycles, it will take. So, 4 cycles, it will take. 4 into 6, 24 years. So, your answer is 24 years. Option B is the right answer. So, 4 times, that is the reason 4 I put base. Total, I need 256 times. In order to get 256, in the power of 4, what I substitute? So, 256 is 16 squared. That is the reason 4 power 4. Each cycle, 6 years. 4 cycles is nothing but 24 years. Right away, we are going to attack directly. All of you okay, Amma? If they given 3 times, we put to base as 3. If 2 times, we put to base as 2. All of you clear, Andy? So, in the exam, we are going to attack directly. This is a small introduction to simple interest and compound interest, Amma. What is SI? What is CA? So, in the regular class, we will cover in-depth analysis. Okay, Amma? So, this is the only a simple introduction to SI and CA. Okay, Amma?